9 Eastern, only here on the Weather Channel. A big threat for drivers on mountain highways is an avalanche. Tonight, see how one group of experts keep a close eye on the piled up snow.
It's the full-time job of a team of avalanche technicians, AvTechs, to keep the snow from reaching the road. They monitor the more than 50 active avalanche chutes that stretch above these mountain highways. It's not just an office job. Today, they need to get a closer look at a section of the snowpack 500 meters above the highway. And there's only one way to get there.
All right.
Snow piles up in layers of different densities.
There's a slight layer in here.
Avalanches happen when a heavy layer breaks free of the snowpack underneath.
The area is known for getting a meter or more of snow overnight. That'll produce avalanches relatively quickly.
And to produce an avalanche, it takes quite a few factors to come together. And we're talking everything from mountain's angle to the weather. And our severe weather expert, Dr. Greg Forbes, has expert analysis now on the science behind avalanches.
Avalanches are big slides of slabs of snow down sloping terrain. It's a combination of weather ingredients as well as the steepness of the terrain that make for the likelihood and then ultimately the size of the avalanche. If the terrain is too steep, then you wind up having so frequent small slides that none of them become very important. If the terrain, on the other hand, is very flat, then even with gravity acting on it, it really can't pull that slab of snow down such flat terrain. But it's slopes that are in between, about 25 to 60 degrees, that's when you get optimal avalanche conditions. The snowpack will build up, and ultimately it'll become too heavy. The friction holding the layer together isn't enough, and you'll get an avalanche, a slide of that snow down the mountain. Weather factors, they're obviously important. Each snowstorm adds new weight of snow to the snowpack, and every snow is different. There can be wet snows, dry snows, and there can be melting, thaws, and then refreezes in between that make an ice layer in between those snow layers. And ultimately, the friction is holding the top layer of snow on, but it can be overcome then once the weight gets too heavy, and there can be sliding on that icy layer. The additional weight overcomes the friction, and then down it comes, a slab of snow sliding down the mountain surface. That's what we call an avalanche. Back to you.
Thank you, Dr. Forbes. Two action-packed hours of Highway Through Hell coming up. That's in just about 2 minutes right here on the Weather Channel, including an all-new episode at 9 p.m. Eastern. That's going to do it for us. Tune in tomorrow morning at 4 o'clock Eastern for the new look of the Weather Channel on the Weather Channel. And right now, we are still looking for some snowflakes in parts of the Midwest. Just wet roads here in downtown Chicago along Michigan Avenue. You can see the lights reflecting on the streets and wet roads out there. Again, 4 o'clock in the morning, brand new look to the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 64 degrees under fair skies. For tonight, overcast, low 48, winds light and variable. And on Tuesday, cloudy skies early followed by partial clearing, high 77. And Tuesday night, clear skies, low 51. Our 7-day outlook.
All right, now it's time for a live weather update here on the Weather Channel. Temperatures are going to be the talk of many towns across the country. Some of the coldest air of the season already invading the U.S. This is a look right now where it's cold in the Twin Cities. Minneapolis, it is 20 degrees right now. St. Paul, 21. Bigger picture showing that the coldest of cold air is not quite to St. Louis. In fact, on this map, you still see a little bit of yellow, but the lighter blues and even some pinks on the way. Those are some really cold temperatures, 12 right now in Fargo, but it feels like 5. It feels like 5 degrees right now in Fargo. Cold air dropping all the way down to the deep south. Wednesday and Thursday morning is going to be very cold from Dallas all the way over to North Florida and throughout parts of the Midwest, including Chicago. High 34 tomorrow. That's it, and still cool on Wednesday.
Hang on to your hats.
This time on the highway through hell.
Is that accident up?
Heavy rescues up against the wall.
No, has to be on the inside.
As the early